This is going to sound crazy, but I think you'll understand. I was 12 the first time I saw the devil. I was in bed, and I was so mad. They went out and left me with the babysitter. I hated being left with the babysitter.
Oh, you're upset, poor baby. Now, come on, dry your eyes, sweetness. I think I've got something to make you feel better. You like candy? There. I bet you're feeling better already now, aren't you? Do you like fairy tales? You know, princesses finding their prince charmings and all that? Well, guess what? I'm going to be your very own Prince Charming. You know what destiny means, don't you? Nah, of course not. You're too young. But that's okay, because I'm going to take care of you. Your whole life, I'm going to be there. And there's nothing I wouldn't do for you. Nothing. Now, I know what you're thinking. What if Mom and Dad don't approve? Well, don't worry your pretty little head about that. I've taken care of everything.
My parents were dead. They died coming home to me. Some part on the car went bad, and the auto company paid a large settlement. But he did it. I know he did. I went to live with my aunt. And I didn't see him again, but I felt his presence. I know he was watching me always. He left candies all over for me, but I never ate them. And he did things too. As soon as I was 18, I bought a car and left town. Even my aunt was glad to see me go. I figured moving would help me escape, that maybe I could outrun what was happening to me. And for a while, I thought it was so. A few years passed without any incidents. Although, thinking back on it, perhaps I just started not to notice them. I can't even remember if the candy kept showing up. I call this my denial phase. I had become relaxed. I let my defenses down.
Beautiful, aren't they?
Yeah, whoever did this is amazing.
You really think so? Thanks.
You?
My name's Matthew.
We talked for a long time. I got lost in it. He was so sweet and unassuming. He even tried to impress me by showing me his prize flowers. He asked me out. I waited for him for an hour, but he never showed up. I was so ashamed of what I'd done.
Forgive me for saying so, sweetness, but puberty was definitely your friend. Sweets for the sweet? No? You do remember me, don't you? Fairy tales, dead parents, Prince Charming, blah, blah, blah. Well, guess what? I'm back. I'd like to think that we were destined to be together. You know, that you were intended for me and I for you, and that every moment since your birth has led up to this, right here, this moment with me. I'm almost the perfect guy once you get to know me. And I don't like to brag, but all that stuff that's happened in your life, like the inheritance, that's me, all me. I did it for you. Because there's nothing I wouldn't do for you. Here, have another piece of candy. There we go. Don't you feel better? One day you'll forget about what's his name over there. Because now you got me, and I'm gonna be your whole world. Your entire universe, and all I want to do is make you happy. I'm gonna take care of everything. It'll be okay, sweetness. I'll be watching you, watching over you. See you soon.
And then he was gone. Only the sickly sweet taste of his candy was left. I realized then that he would never let me be, and I almost gave up. If he had pressed me any more at that time, I could not have resisted him. So I took all of my money and took to the road. I wasn't going to run anymore, though now I was in search of something. There had to be some way out of this mess, and I had enough means to buy my way to the solution. It wasn't easy, though. That kind of information is hard to find, And it costs a fortune for leads that come up against dead ends again and again. And the candy, always the candy showed up. Sometimes he would show up as well. He started becoming curious, trying to find out what I was up to, but I never gave it away. And so the years went by, consumed by the search for some knowledge that didn't exist until I found it in a dusty tome of ancient, forbidden lore. I discovered that he wasn't what I thought he was at all. I believed he was the devil, but I found a tale of a lesser being, a demon that had throughout the ages fixated on a woman from childhood and courted her into womanhood. I know it all sounds crazy, unbelievable, but it has to be true. The thing about demons, I learned, is that if you speak their true name, the name they keep hidden, then you have power over them. They can't harm you and can be banished from ever coming to you again. In this tome was recorded the true name of this demon, and I learned it. I committed to memory his name. Your name. To use against you.
Aw, sweetness, you found me out. I could never truly fool you, now could I? I hate to tell you, but that bit of research you did, it's all bunk. Old wives do love their tales. It's useless. It's not gonna work against me.
There's only one way to know for sure. Good night, honey. See you tomorrow.
Well, hello there, sweetness. Do you like candy?